Don't dance with me. You don't have to admit you. You don't have to admit you. I wanna play Hello and welcome to today's hands-only CPR training. I'm Kitty Hoffman, a member of your American Heart Association team. And joining me as my fellow MC today is Costas Johnson. Just a few housekeeping items before we jump right in. Please be sure to switch your view to speaker view rather than gallery view so you can see the person speaking predominantly on your screen. And put your thoughts, questions, and comments in the chat box because we'll have some time at the end to address them. Now, why are we all here? We're here because October is Sudden Cardiac Arrest Awareness Month. So let's kick off our time together with a really awesome video.
He's not ready.
All right.
Yeah.
All right.
Moldy.
Slingshot.
It's definitely a romantic
comedy. Wait, what is my wave?
No, you drink
the whole shirt, man. The heart attack sequel.
Falling down.
You can tell by the way I use my walk. I'm a woman's man. No time to talk. You see love when they walk. They engage around. Since I was born, it was all right. I don't care. You may look the other way. But we can try to understand.
Whatever happened to you? Harmless game of charade based on film titles turning into a sudden cardiac event. Bam! Chiclocky! No? What? I think you're better than me? Well, it happens, all right? It's a real life situation! I got my daughters here. Call 911. Push hard and fast, okay? Focus! And yes, the beat of staying alive really works. Shama!
Disco can save lives. Yes, disco, huh? Check it out. What do you think? What? Dance party!
All right, well, thank you all for joining. Such a great video that was for many reasons. Shocking always to learn that 70% of out-of-hospital cardiac arrests happen at home, which is, you know, huge. And I think that we can all, you know, remember the beat to staying alive. Shortly, you will hear a story that demonstrates why knowing hands-only CPR is so important.
But before we transition to that, we want to thank our local sponsors, Clark Pacific and Pacific Coast Building Products, for their incredible support of our local trainers like yourself with curriculum and training kits, through the funding of a hands-only CPR kiosk at the Golden One Center, and through community event training like today, to train thousands of people in this life-saving skill. Thank you, Clark.
I think we might be having a little issues with Kitty's microphone. I will say that we wanted to thank Yes Clark Pacific and Pacific Coast Builders for all the work that they're doing. Trainings, they do have the CPR kiosk that was at the Golden One Center. They are really training thousands of our community members with CPR. So we thank you so much. Without further ado, I would like to introduce our amazing volunteer for the American Heart Association, Bob Clark. Bob is the president of Clark Pacific. He is here to share his story of survival. Bob is a tremendous advocate for our mission and has no doubt saved lives with his powerful message. Bob, we hand it over to you. Let me see, it might be having some technical difficulties. Gotta love technology.
2020. But while we're waiting for Bob to jump on and tell his incredible story, why don't you start sharing your thoughts, your comments, your questions in the chat box? We'll have some time at the end to answer those questions.
Thanks, guys. Welcome to hands-only CPR training. Let me tell you why CPR training is so important to me. When I was 42 years old, I started to, was playing basketball with my son and said, boy, I'm getting out of shape. And so I started jogging. You know, every night I'd come home and jog and went a little further every day. And I remember one day coming home and all the kids are there. And I said, who wants to go jog with me? And of course, no one did. And as I was running out the door, one of the kids said, hey, don't die. Joke, joke, joke. And half a mile down the road, I face plant and had a, you know, basically my heart stopped. And I happened to fall in front of a house that typically no one's out in their yards at this time. And a young boy had been pestering his dad to come out and do play with his bike. And his dad said, no, no, no. And finally, he let him do it. And he no sooner did he walk out into the driveway, he sees me fall over. And luckily, his dad was home. He's never home. He's always he's a hospital doctor, and just happened to be home that day. And within 30 seconds, the son ran and got his dad. His dad told him to call 911, and then he administered hands-free CPR, hands-only CPR to me. Until the ambulance got there. So I think it was eight different times of trying to get my heart restarted again before it finally did. So I'm one of the fortunate ones. And if we can just save one life, it's so important. So please enjoy the hands-only CPR training. And I also want to do another shout out to Clark Pacific's business partners, who's helped in our fundraising campaign. And this year we raised over $150,000 to help support this type of training for our community. I think over the last 6 or 7 years, it's been over $800,000 of fundraising. So thank you all very much. And please enjoy your hands-only CPR training.
Thank you so much for sharing your story, Bob. Always great to see you. You are such an inspiration to so many of us, and we cannot thank you, your team, and your business partners enough for the absolutely amazing support.
Yes, we're just about to begin today's training. I know that's why you're all here. Before we do, we'd like to introduce you to our health expert that's here today with us, Anu Locricchio, who is here to help provide some insight on this important topic. Anu is the Director of Cardiovascular Services for Dignity Health Sacramento Division. Anu, thank you so much for joining us today. We just heard Bob's incredible story. Can you tell us a little bit more about why learning hands-only CPR is so important?
Yes, thank you for having me. It's such an honor to be a part of this very important education. 70%, as you mentioned earlier, 70% of out-of-hospital cardiac arrests occur in the community, in your own home. And so only 46% of individuals who experience this out-of-hospital cardiac arrest will actually receive the immediate help that they need from professionals. And so every minute counts. If you're called to save somebody's life, likely it will be somebody you love and somebody that you know. CPR, if performed immediately, can double or triple a cardiac arrest victim's chance for survival. And it's all about survival.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Anu, and thank you for being with us. To let everyone know, Anu will be around following this demo to take any questions that you have. If you have them already, you can type them into the chat box and we will get to them as soon as we're done with the demo.
And now it's time to learn hands-only CPR. In less than 5 minutes, you'll learn the simple steps that can help save a life. So make sure your volume is all the way up and let's roll the video.
Hi everyone, my name is Manny Medina and I'm a longtime volunteer with the American Heart Association. So let's talk about hands-only CPR. If you ever have to utilize hands-only CPR, it's more than likely going to happen inside your own home to somebody that you love. And that's because 70% of the cardiac arrest that occurs in the United States happens at your home. CPR, hands-only CPR can actually triple the chances of survival. It's so easy to learn and it's so effective. Every second counts when somebody is suffering cardiac arrest outside the hospital. And you performing something like hands-only CPR can save their lives. So I want to show you guys how to do that today. If you have a hands-only CPR kit from the American Heart Association, let's get it ready right now. So blow up the mannequin that comes inside the kit, get that nice and ready. If you don't have a hands-only CPR kit, it's perfectly fine. You can use a stuffed animal, you can use a couple pillows, whatever you have within your own home that can help you learn this very, very simple technique. So let's get all of that ready so that way I can actually show you how to save a life. So whenever somebody suffers cardiac arrest outside the hospital, all you have to do to save their life is perform these two simple steps. The first thing that you want to do is call for help. So dial 911, get those EMTs and paramedics that are going to provide the advanced life support that is necessary in order to make sure that we can save their life. And while we're waiting for them, you're going to perform step two, which is just to push hard and fast on the center of the chest until help arrives. Okay, so take the center of your, or the palm of your hand, and we're going to place that right onto your CPR Anytime Kit mannequin, or your stuffed animal, or your pillow, whatever you got. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna push down hard and fast until help gets there. We're gonna go at a rate of about 100 compressions per minute. It helps to think of your favorite song. Staying Alive by the Bee Gees, Walk the Line by Johnny Cash, Crazy in Love by Jay-Z and Beyonce, any upbeat song that can help you perform the compressions long enough until the help gets there. So it's really that simple. So call for help, push hard and fast on the center of the chest until help gets there. That's all you have to do in order to become a lifesaver. Thank you guys for coming today to join me during this training. So now go out, save a bunch of lives, and thank you for being here. Bye guys.
Awesome. It is so simple, and we hope you all are feeling like you can help step in should you ever need to. And I don't know about you all, but staying alive will officially be stuck in my head for at least all of today, which is great.
Yes, quite a few shout outs. We're not sponsored by them, you know. we have a few minutes now. Let's ask our medical expert Anu some questions. I saw there was a few already that populated, but starting off, Anu, I did want to ask you our first question, which is, since October is Sudden Cardiac Arrest Awareness Month, can you explain the difference between a heart attack and a cardiac arrest? People often use these terms interchangeably, but I know that's not the case.
Yeah, that's a great question. So cardiac arrest is actually when your heart stops to beat. That's an electrical problem. A heart attack is when there's a reduced flow of blood, which is reducing also the oxygen necessary needs and the demands of the heart. If there's a reduced flow or a blocked flow, that's actually a circulatory problem. Both of them will require immediate treatment. Cardiac arrest, if you have hands-only CPR for cardiac arrest, your chances of survival are very, very good. So it's really important that you're not afraid to do the hands-only CPR.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for clarifying that. And we've got some great questions rolling in the chat box, so I'll just read one of those out. So how can you be sure someone actually needs CPR? When do you step in?
You can ask them if they're doing okay. If they respond, they're awake and they likely will not require CPR, but may require medical attention. So it's always advisable to call 911 once you see somebody's in distress. If you check for a pulse, you can check right by your thumb. There's a pulse check. You can do that or here on your neck. And if you feel a pulse, then they likely don't need CPR. Also, it's always important to see if they're responsive. Most people in the community with cardiac arrest will do exactly what Bob did. It's face planting, and you can tell that they're in distress and require some help. At the end of the day, if you give CPR to somebody who maybe didn't need it, it's not going to hurt them. It's better to be right there for them and call 911 and go ahead and start your hands-only CPR.
Awesome. Thank you for clarifying. I know that's super helpful in the moment. I'm sure everyone's kind of nervous, not sure what to do. So jumping in and taking action, great idea.
Yes. And, you know, I did see a question come through about the sternum as well, about injuring. So it's always better to perform hands-only CPR than to worry about injuring the person. So thank you for that. These are great questions. I do see another one that asks, is there a possibility of doing compressions too fast or too slow?
Well, if you got the rhythm in your head, you're going to do something that's going to help somebody stay alive. The damage that can be done by CPR is very minimal, some bruising. It's better than not being with us. And so doing it too fast or too slow is really just more of a mental thing. If you just continue to do rhythmic, high quality CPR, fast and hard, that's the key. Right in the center of the chest, you will help to save someone's life.
Thank you.
Awesome, thank you.
Yeah, Katie, I don't know if you saw another one, yeah.
I did, a lot of really great questions. I hope we can get to them all. Should we check the airway before starting compressions? And kind of paired up with that, why are we doing hands-only CPR and not doing the breaths anymore?
Such great questions. Yeah, it's always important to check the airway if you can. So we always advise you take a look at somebody's mouth and neck area and make sure it's in an optimal position and not kinked. That said, the most important part of CPR is actually doing the high quality compressions over the sternum. Every minute counts, and the chance of survival is increased by 10% for every minute. As we waste our time wondering what to do, every minute gone is a 10% decrease in their survival rates for those individuals that experience this particular phenomena. So it's very important just to get on that chest and go hard and fast. And in the pandemic, there's been many studies during the pandemic that chest compressions have just as good outcomes in the likelihood of survival rather than just worrying about doing the mouth to mouth. We have actually really advocated that in the community, we don't worry about mouth to mouth. We just focus on your hands over the chest and pushing hard and fast.
Thank you. And I think that that's great information, especially, you know, with COVID, everything going, you know, germs are something that is everybody's worried about. So I think knowing that you can still save a life and be effective without, you know, mouth to mouth is great information. Kitty, I don't know.
Okay, yeah. There you go. So Roseanne asks, how long do you continue to push? So how do you know when to stop performing CPR?
So a lot of times we get this question. Hopefully you're not alone when you're doing CPR on somebody. You can cause a commotion and ask for help. You've already dialed 911, or somebody that's checked on you on the situation has already dialed 911. And you continue to perform CPR until professional help arrives. So we ask that you do not discontinue. It is so important that you can rotate out with others, if there's others that are around you, your neighbors, others in the house. But if not, you continue as long as you can until the help arrives. And that will help increase the survival opportunity for those patients and individuals in our community.
You bring up a great point. The more people we can get CPR certified and trained, the better likelihood that person has of surviving if you do need to switch out. So thank you all for being here today. That's making a big difference. Here, is it harmful to do hands-only CPR on children or people who are pregnant?
Good question. Well, we advocate that we do hands-only CPR for teenagers. So anybody who's like an adult size body, that's who you would want to do the hands-only CPR. Techniques for babies, toddlers, and very young children are different. And so that would require some more education. And we would definitely ask you to come to the American Heart Association and check out our infant and baby CPR. But doing CPR on adults and teens with hands only will very much increase your likelihood of survival.
Thank you. I did see a follow-up question about the sternum. Is it most effective if you break the sternum during the compressions, or is that a myth? I don't believe so, but I leave it to the expert.
So I will say, in my career over the last 25 years, we don't really break the sternum. It's a very short and small bone. And if you have your hand right over that area and you give it a couple of inches of pushing hard and fast, you're not going slow enough that you're going to put so much force in it. You're going fast and you're recoiling fast. And so when you're doing that, the likelihood of breaking the sternum is very, very slim. There is a small little bone underneath the sternum. Sometimes that will break off. It really is so insignificant when you compare, you know, that alternative to not being here. So the most important thing is really to not think about maybe harm, because there is bruising, it's uncomfortable, but at least the person is alive and part of our society and our community. So I would advocate for, don't worry about any damage done. Studies have shown that hands-only CPR saves lives.
Thank you. Yes, I think that is the, you know, biggest takeaway, I think, is if you can perform it, perform it. The difference between life or death is much bigger than a broken, you know, bone or something. So thank you. Kitty, do you see another question?
I don't see another question, but I do see a link to CPR certification course that you can log in and take. But you know, you've really taken that first important step of joining us here today, asking your all important questions, paying attention, and you know, I hope you all feel confident and comfortable in your abilities now.
Yes, we still have a little bit of time. So if you do have questions, feel free to write them in the chat box. We'll try and get to them before our time is up. That is all we had planned for today. So thank you so much for joining us. Following our time today, we will be sending out this recorded training video so that you can share it with your friends or family. If you have any follow-up questions as well, feel free to email myself or Kitty. We'll get that information if you don't already have it as well.
And then of course, we'd be remiss if we didn't thank our incredible supporters again, Clark Pacific, Pacific Coast Building Products, and you, Anu, for your incredible support, your information, your expertise. We really appreciate you. And I hope everyone has a wonderful rest of their week.
Yes. Now, I did see one other question, Anu, before. And again, you know, if you want to take off and leave the training, that's absolutely okay. We'll try and get some of these last questions. One of them, I just missed it because I had it, but could you show where the the ideal place on the body is to do the compressions?
Yeah, so right in between your breastbone, actually. You can feel it. So if you just take your fingertips and just go down your neck and you'll feel a hard bone in the center. That's really good hand placement for you to do high quality compressions for your loved one or for whomever's in the community. And you can feel it, it's right there. It's a bone that's 3 to 4 inches. Put your hands in position and hard and fast.
All right, Laura, so that you were right. Smack dab in the middle, it looks like.
And when do you stop and check your pulse again or check the individual's pulse again?
That's a great question. We've gone back and forth so many times on when to do a pulse check. Again, it's just about you taking the time, no more than 10 seconds to do a pulse check. But if you've been doing CPR for a while and you think that maybe it's been effective, it's always a good idea to go ahead and check and see if you have a return pulse. You can do it right here at the neck or right here down below by your wrist. Just give yourself 10 seconds. If you don't feel anything or you're unsure, go right back to hands-only CPR.
Awesome. And then we got another question as well. They just keep coming in. This is great. To clarify again, no need of CPR if the person is awake?
Yeah, so if they're awake, good job. You saved life. That's excellent. They still may need help, and it's always a good idea to make sure that 911 was called and that they're on their way. But if somebody's awake, they won't need CPR.
Awesome. Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right. I think that might be all of the questions.
Yeah, we still have quite a few on. So I appreciate, Anu, thank you for all of your answers. Just a couple more minutes, but if there's any other questions that you have, please send them in. If not, thank you again for joining us today. We appreciate it. We hope you got something out of this. Thank you to Clark Pacific and Pacific Coast Building Products as well. All right, you know what, there's no more questions. I feel like we could let everybody have some time back in their day. So thank you all again. If you do have questions that you didn't get to answer, feel free to send them to Kitty or myself. Thank you all so much for joining. And now hopefully you feel confident to save a life.
Thanks, everyone.
Thank you, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you, Anu.